It's star 1978, star 8378. I'm in this pattern. I'm watching Stranger Things season 4, episode 3. Chapter 3 opens with the monster and the superhero. They're speaking on 11. There's a man who gets, or no, I'm sorry, I apologize. It's not a man. There's a piecemeal. PIECEMEAL that steps out of a helicopter that just arrives on someone's property. And he's speaking to this man who was working on something and then got fired because under this man's watch, a foreign government invaded and then he was fired. Now, the piecemeal. Which looks like a freed slave, according to the Big Five, and what they're documenting slaves looked like, even under freedmen in an 1865 Civil War, whatever. They were to be returned directly to the South. Now there's a problem. Now there's been an invasion in the White House within my children's life frame. Because of corrupt citizens actively moving around inside of the territory. This is a problem. It puts local, state, and federal government in threat and harm's way. And then the storyline seems to be having trouble, like really holding fast, steadfast. At Homestead Rescue. So I'm watching this and it says it's Ruth and then it says Ne Veda, although the humans around here call it Nevada, but it reads Nevada. Now, is that supposed to be a Veda text representative? I'm just curious at Stranger Things. But the conversation is. The southern looking slave is now in a uniform and speaking to the man, or the piecemeal is speaking to the man, and he's blaming the man who's fired, which is a real problem because I'm like, he's not in a uniform, he's not in a power position. He was fired because they found out there were other governments working with inside the government. So if all of the active government is then fired, who's running the show? That's the really frightening part. Because the not us is now in a uniform that has a collar brace that says us. And I'm like, this is a bigger problem than anyone's speaking on. And not only that, the thing inside of a US uniform is trying to say that the man is the one who's to blame because he's the one who opened this door through science. I don't know why you'd give that level of education to the not us if they're just going to turn around and put the entire population in danger. Or harm's way. Just saying. Because I see a whole lot of area management in New York actively promoting this piecemeal in this US storyline. I mean, what happened? Why, how did Obama break into the White House, into the family estate, without welcome, unannounced? Well, let's look for clues, shall we? At Blue's Clues. It says Stranger Things, and this is the episode S4E3. 43, what a big surprise. Chapter 3, The Monster and the Superhero. And there it is, Ruth Nevada. Now, I've had this happen in New York without a helicopter landing. Sam. Now, is that Uncle Sam reference? I'm just curious, because these things matter. And his name is Sullivan.
No signs of any attacker. No bruises. No signs of any struggle. It's as if her attacker was a ghost. Does this remind you of anything, Doctor?
No. Doesn't.
Are you sure?
Why are you here? Really?
I like your opinion.
I was fired, in case you forgot.
A foreign government invaded our country all under your watch. Badly consequences.
That would be their foreign government.
I understand.
The piecemeal.
Something is going on in that town that nobody fully comprehends. And I also understand that military strength is not the answer. So what is the answer, Doctor? More scientists? Because it's men of science, men like you, who created this problem in the first place. Everything that has happened in Hawkins can be traced back to Brennan's little pet. Wouldn't you agree?
Now that's an interesting way to spin the story, because last time I checked, I don't understand why this piecemeal would keep landing inside of the Big Five's jurisdiction and territory, asking questions when the Big Five needs to conduct its own investigation without outside foreign body intervention or obstruction of getting to a safe conclusion for public health priority. But here we are at, there's a real divide and problem in the actual lead-in storyline as well. A break in reality, as portrayed by
assassinations.
What you're suggesting is impossible.
Is it?
11 is dead.
I'm not convinced.
So where has she been all this time?
There are rumors she's alive and receiving help from someone on the inside.
Are you saying I'm helping her? Is that what you're saying?
If I wanted to chat, Doctor, I would have picked up the damn phone. You can make this easy and tell us where she is. Or we can't do this the hard way.
Let's see, what are they teaching in the local schools after the break-in and before in this symbolic whatever? They're still teaching the Big Five: Irish, Swedish, German, European Jew, and Italian. Big Five. What they're not teaching is whatever is having problems in this local USA territory, because the green linen that they use as monetary currency and so on and so forth, the origins, the founding fathers, there's unity and construct in social as well as big area protection with the way that this was constructed and the way that it was documented and the way that it was taught in this corridor, where there's real problem is with this new, I don't know if it's an isolated incident of some other area foreign government body pushing in and trying to act like tenants in common is something acceptable or to strive for or even to grow the problem. That's where it gets a little confusing, being a parent and then having like foster issues and custodial issues, janitorial issues, gardening issues, all sorts of things. And then not having the words or a person of my own to speak to, because in the guise of a democracy that they put a donkey label on it, it feels as though they tied me to this donkey and dragged me the last 4 decades like some jackass on the back end.